Chandy, yeah, it's something we've been talking about for a while now. A partial solar eclipse is going to hit right here in the Pittsburgh region. Now, as exciting as that is, and thousands of people are expected to flock out to see it, I did speak to someone from the Carnegie Science Center who tells me there are a few things you should know before heading out to view that eclipse.
We've all been hearing the phrase solar eclipse for quite some time now, and tomorrow it's finally here. But you still might be wondering, well, what even is a solar eclipse?
A solar eclipse is when the Earth, the Moon, and the Sun are in alignment. And there's a couple different types of eclipses that occur. So we have, you know, the one that we're really talking about now, which is our total solar eclipse. That is when it fully covers the Sun. And all we are left with is a small corona of the Sun's atmosphere we're able to see.
And with some amazing experience comes safety concerns. We normally don't just stare up at the Sun. As tempting as it might be tomorrow, it is super important to not stare directly at the eclipse. It's why having eclipse glasses for tomorrow is very important.
The eclipse glasses will allow you to be able to stare at the Sun for a prolonged period of time. They're hundreds of times stronger than your typical sunglasses. So it's really important, especially here in Pittsburgh, that anytime you're outside and you're staring up at the Sun, that you're wearing those eclipse glasses.
And that counts for the photos you'll want to take on your smartphones as well. That can come at a price.
So your phone actually is able to collect those rays and can fry. And so again, you know, like we think about our eyes, but the lenses on our phone are also pretty sensitive, and telescopes are pretty sensitive that you have to get special filters.
Now again, Pittsburgh is not in the path of totality, except partial totality. That means now the moon will not be blocking the sun completely for about those 2.5 hours. There will be about 3% of the sun rays hitting through. Now again, the eclipse will start around 2 p.m. and end around 4 p.m. And something very important to note, officials are reminding drivers to not pull over on the shoulder of the road to view that eclipse. Reporting live from outside the Carnegie Science Center, Yasmin Rodriguez, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.